Welcome. In this video, we are introducing our rapid prototyping software called X2C. X2C is a tool for model-based development and automated code generation of real-time control algorithms for microprocessors. The tool is using Xcodes from Scilab or Simulink from MATLAB as a front-end, where the user quickly creates his model graphically by connecting pre-designed X2C blocks. Once the model has been set up, the C code can be created automatically with a simple mouse click. After compilation, the application can be easily transferred to the target using the X2C communicator. The powerful and intuitive tuning and debugging capabilities of X2C make the development process easier and faster. And last but not least, X2C also supports an automatically generated documentation of the used model. But let's start from the beginning. We start off by showing an application model created in Scilab Xcodes. The application is a simple speed controller for a permanent magnet synchronous motor. This application is used to demonstrate the simple workflow of X2C using Scilab. To give you an idea of how the assembling of the model is done and which blocks are available for modeling, the palette browser is opened. We shortly browse through the X2C libraries and the containing blocks. The C code behind the blocks within the libraries has been elaborately tested for numerous targets. For adding a block, simply select the block in the library and drag and drop it into your model. Here, we select a PT1 low-pass filter. Okay, let's put the PT1 block to the speed controller. Therefore, we now cut out the block and insert it again in the speed control subsystem. Now the block only needs to be connected to the controller. Double-clicking the block opens the block mask, and a short description of the block is found at the top of it. Below the description, the block implementation is easily defined via a drop-down menu. Either fixed point 16 or 32 bits, or floating point 32 or 64 bits can be selected. The 8-bit fixed point implementation is expiring. A mixture of various implementations within a model is possible, and the chosen implementation is not restricted by the target's hardware architecture. For editing the parameter, you may choose to use the left or the right field. The left field allows the use of variables, but numerical values can also be entered. In the right field, values can be entered using the keyboard and changed with the arrow buttons or the scroll wheel of the mouse. In the example given, we choose the 16-bit fixed point implementation, with gain set to 1, cutoff frequency set to 20 Hz, and the Tustin's method for discretization. Since we have added the PT1 block to the model, we have to create the new C code from the changed model and download the changes to the target. From this point on, creating the C code is a three-step process. In a first step, the X2C communicator has to be started by double-clicking the orange model block named Start Communicator. Afterwards, as a second step, the model must be analyzed and transferred to the communicator. The last and third step is to click the Create Code button of the communicator. However, before that, the X2C communicator will be shown briefly. The X2C communicator is started by a double click on the orange block with the label Start Communicator. In order to be prepared for the next tasks, we now quickly rearrange the windows. The X2C communicator connects the target system to the model. It provides a connection to the target via a serial, a CAN or an Ethernet interface. Due to this data connection, no programming device is required for downloading the binaries of the application, and the tuning and debugging of the application is significantly simplified. Now we disconnect from the target and switch to the Setup tab, where the parameter of the communication can be set. One has to specify the used interface and its properties. The currently used target is connected via a serial interface on port COM9. By pressing the Refresh Ports button, the currently available ports are updated in the drop-down menu. After setting the communication parameters, we switch back to the Status tab. Let's clean the log window to delete old messages. By clicking the Connect to Target button, the communicator tries to establish a connection to the target. The changed image of the button and the message in the log window are indicating that the connection has been established successfully. Now, we continue the C code generation process. The communicator has been started successfully. As a second step, the model must be analyzed and transferred to the communicator. This is achieved by double-clicking the orange block named Transform Model and push to Communicator. The window named Model Transformation opens. And once it says Model Transformation done, you may proceed. And third, the creation of the C code is done by clicking the Create Code button of X2C Communicator. If everything works just fine, the line Create Code Successful appears in the log window. Since a new C code has been created, we have to compile new binaries for the target. We change to the proper integrated development environment, which here is the Code Compositor Studio, and recompile the project containing the X2C C code. Once this is done successfully, and the X2C communicator is connected to the target, we choose the binaries that are supposed to be transferred to the target. This is done by clicking the Download Settings button in X2C Communicator. Enter the path to the binaries and click OK. The transfer is started by clicking the Download Application to the Target button. The Flash Problem window appears, telling that the power electronics was on and running and has to be set to idle state while flashing the binaries. We confirm the change of the internal state and start the transfer. On the power electronics, the transfer of the application is indicated by the flashing red LED. Now, we will show how easy it is to debug, to tune and to control the system with X2C. The mask of the enable switch block is opened by a double click, and its parameter is set to 1. This change is automatically transferred to the target. The output of this block is connected to the out block named PWM enable, which enables the power electronics, and the machine starts turning. In the small window, you can now see the rotating motor. The speed may be changed using the X2C constant block named N1. Since the implementation of block N1 was chosen to be of 16-bit fixed point, the desired reference speed is scaled to a value of 5000 RPM. Therefore, the value 0.02 refers to a reference speed of 100 RPM. The speed is increased in adjustable steps, using the arrow buttons. By double-clicking the display block, the current speed is read from the target and displayed in the block. On the system itself, and in the display block, you can see that the motor now rotates faster. You may also change the speed simply by turning the mouse wheel, while the mouse is placed over the active right field in the parameter editor. Next, we are introducing a very handy tool for developing rapid prototyping applications. That's our virtual oscilloscope, called X2C Scope, which is great for observing signals when debugging your application. It has many features known from oscilloscopes, like a configurable trigger unit, up to 8 channels to scope simultaneously, and a single shot versus continuous sampling mode. It allows saving and loading of scope configurations, and enables data export to MATLAB or Scilab for further processing. We are going to show some basic use cases of the X2C scope. First case is the instantaneous observation of the speed signal with high time resolution. The sampling time factor is therefore set to 1. At the beginning, the trigger mode is set to auto. Unwanted channels are disabled by unchecking the enable checkbox. One can choose 8 different colors for signal representation. There are 4 different types of channel sources: a signal at a certain memory address, a block port, an I/O port, and a global application variable. We have chosen the block port type for both channels. The first channel scopes the port out of a rate limiter block named rate limiter, located in the subsystem speed control, which refers to the reference speed. The second channel scopes the port out of the PT1 block, which refers to the current speed signal. With setting the channel gains to 5000, the signals are displayed in RPM. With the sample button, the sampling process is started. The displayed speeds are in the range of 100 RPM. Now, the speed is changed and the signals are monitored. The second case waits for an event and records signals around this event. The sample time factor is set to 60. The trigger mode is changed to normal. And scoping of channel 3 and channel 4 is enabled, which finally ends up in a scope time interval of 3675 milliseconds. The signal on channel 3 refers to the reference current for the current controller, and the signal on channel 4 refers to the measured current. Now the speed oscillation mode is activated by setting the parameter of the block named mode switch to 1. The signals are plotted for a bit longer than one period of the oscillation. By watching this video, you have been introduced to some basics of creating X2C models with SciLab. Also the workflow of generating C code from a X2C model and downloading resulting binaries to the target was shown. And finally we introduced our X2C scope with two simple use cases. If you have any more questions or want to have some more information concerning X2C, please have a look at our website x2c.lcm.at and do not hesitate to contact us. Thanks for watching.